Hello everyone, my name is Snigdha Subrashmita and I got 100 percentile in English NTA UGC NET December 2018. This was my second attempt. In the first attempt in July, I couldn't make it. My score was 154, but the general cutoff was 156. So I was I got 2 marks less. But this time my marks are 202, that is 67.33%, and it's the highest in English. I graduated from Ravenshaw University, which is in Odisha, and I am the gold medalist of my batch 2017. And my post-graduation is from English and Foreign Languages University, and I specialized in English literature. So NET and JRF. NET is National Eligibility Test and JRF is Junior Research Fellowship. It's conducted twice in a year. Since last December, it's been conducted by NTA. And when you clear NET, that is National Eligibility Test, you are eligible to be an assistant professor in the colleges and universities in India. But when you clear a JRF, you are eligible for the fellowship from the government to pursue your higher studies, say PhD, in your area of interest. For NET to write the exam, you have to get 55% in your master degree if you are a general, and if you belong to some reserved category, then you should have 50% in your master's degree. And the exam has two papers, paper 1 and paper 2, and the students will have to attempt all the questions, like 150 questions in all, in both paper 1 and 2. In paper 1, there are 50 questions and the time given is 1 hour. In paper 2, that is your subject, it has 100 questions and the time given is 2 hours. So, total there are 150 questions and 3 hours. There is no negative marking in NET. So, you have to attempt each and every question even if you don't know the answer. And the students who clear NET, top 6% of the candidates who clear NET will be selected for JRF. And you are eligible to be a professor or assistant professor when you clear NET. It's not only that people who clear NET are eligible for professor or assistant professor, the post. There are certain public sectors which offer jobs to students who have cleared NET. Public sectors like IOCL, BHEL like Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, Oil India Limited. There are certain public sectors like this which offer jobs to candidates who have cleared NET. They ask for your scorecard to give you a job. So today I'll share my strategy, like what I did for the exam and how I prepared, and I hope this will help you guys. So I followed the reverse approach. I solved the previous year questions first. Once you solve the question paper, the previous year questions, you understand the requirements of the exam and you get to know what to read and what not to read. And then I followed a test-based approach, solve as many questions as you can so that you know what to read and you can segregate it from the things which you don't have to read. And then keep in your mind the requirements of the exam and that will help you. Make a proper strategy and a timetable and make clear, concise notes. The advantages of note making is that you know what you have read and you know how where all your materials are consolidated. So, you know what to read and it limits your sources, and that is what you have to do, like minimalize your sources so that you have one proper source to read for NET. Coming to paper 1, see, give equal importance to both paper 1 and paper 2 because both the marks counts in the exam, and if you can get some more marks in paper 1, that will make all the difference. And in paper 1, there is a proper syllabus, you know what is going to be asked, so that makes it more easier. And in paper 1, there are two types of questions, like knowledge and fact-based questions, and the other one is procedure-based questions, which you have to solve using certain formulas. And in paper 1, there are 10 topics, research aptitude, teaching aptitude, comprehension, communication, information technology, logical reasoning and mathematical reasoning, data interpretation, people and environment, higher education and government. So there are questions from each of these topics and you have to prepare them. What I did was I brought two books, one by Arihant and the other one was by KVS Madan. I solved all the questions, the previous year questions and the test papers and mock questions which they give in the book, and I practiced. Like, solving as many questions as you can will help you in paper 1. And for current affairs, I read the newspaper every day. I saw Gaurav sir's video and I practiced many current affair modules and question paper. It's easily available in internet. You can just download and solve them. And then coming to paper 2, see, in English the syllabus is so vast that people say that there is no syllabus in English because it's just drama, prose, poetry, novel, and in drama almost everything comes. And English literature is not only the history of British literature, it's all the literatures in English, like Indian English, American English, and post-colonial English literature. All the literatures, you have to read that because they all come under the arena of English literature, all the Commonwealth literature. So what you need to do is you prepare a proper strategy, divide the syllabus into parts, and then make daily, weekly and monthly targets. So how do you divide the syllabus? Say for example, you make a timetable that in 1 month you will complete British literature, and then minimize your sources. Like, these are the books from which you are going to study British literature. See, there is no one book for net. You have to read multiple sources and then consolidate everything into your own notes, and that is the best source for the exam. So you make a list of writers from the books. I'm going to say about the books. You make a list of writers and then go for their canonical famous works, and then take a look at their minor works and read your syllabus, your graduation and post-graduation syllabus thoroughly. When you read your syllabus thoroughly, like, most of the canonical works are covered in the graduation and post-graduation syllabus. And if you feel that your syllabus is not good enough, the university in which you are studying, then just go to any central university website, download their syllabus and read the entire syllabus of graduation and post-graduation, and that will help you a lot. And if you cannot read a book, if you don't have time enough to read all the books and dramas and novels, just read their summary and make a table, write the writer name and his works and how that work is important, what are the major characters in the work, and that will help you. For history of English literature, I followed Routledge History of English Literature and Oxford History of English Literature, which is by Andrew Sanders. And for literary theory and criticism, I didn't know what to read. So I started with Beginning Theory by Peter Barry, and then I read M.A.R. Habib, and that is the best book as far as I have read. But still, you don't get all the information from the books. So Google search everything which you don't find, and internet is your best friend if you are preparing for NET. And for American literature, Richard Gray's History of American Literature is good. And for Indian literature, A.K. Mehrotra's book on Indian literature is good. And yes, there are other books like M.H. Abrams is a must for NET in English. You have to read the book from cover to cover. And this time there are some new addition in the new syllabus, like cultural studies and non-fiction writings. See, in cultural studies, if you go for Simon Deering and all the big books, it's going to take a lot of time, and you don't have enough time to read all those books, and the cost benefit ratio is very low when you read all that. As for my suggestion, Pramod Ken Iyer's Cultural Studies is a good book because the language is very simple and you can actually understand what he is saying in the book. And non-fiction writings, yes. In non-fiction writings, everything comes, like Bible translation, letters, periodicals, essays, the essays of Hazlitt, almost everything. The letters, or is there question bhi aaye the, like Journal to Stella was written by Jonathan Swift, and it was addressed to whom, how many, there are 65 letters, it was addressed to Esther and Rebecca Dingley. So you need to know everything, and it's not possible to read almost everything. When you go through the previous year question paper and the syllabus, and may divide your syllabus and know the requirements of the exam, you can segregate what to read and what not to read. And then, yeah, go for the literary movements and the canonical texts, the contemporary writers, the subtitles, like Is Bahar Aaye The Ki, Caleb Williams, Things As They Are, or know your strong and weak areas, and then reading won't help you. You have to revise and practice. So when you make notes, like half of the things are there in your mind, and when you revise them again and again, you cannot forget that. And sometimes, even if you don't know the correct answer, by seeing the other answer, you can eliminate some options, and that will lead you to the correct answer eventually. Practice and solve questions as much as you can. See, consistency is the key to success, and keep reading with a positive attitude. Like, if you think and feel and you are confident enough that you can crack this exam, eventually you will. The exam is made difficult for a purpose, and NET always appreciates hard work as well as smart work. So just plan accordingly, and failure will never overtake you if your determination to succeed is strong enough. So be confident, develop in small steps, and believe in yourself, have faith in your abilities, and yes, you are good to go. If you have any queries, questions or suggestions, please mention it in the comment section below. I'll reply to each one of you, and those who are appearing for the next exam in June, all the best to them. And yeah, thank you so much.